Hey friends, I'm Scott Hanselman. This is another episode of Azure Friday. I'm here with Amber Bhargava, and we're talking about the new Azure free account.
That's correct.
I remember the very first time that I signed up for Azure free account. If I remember, I got a couple $100 mm-hmm. and then I converted it eventually to a pay-as-you-go account.
Sure. Yeah, so as you said, Scott, we used to have the Azure free trial offer, mm-hmm. which used to offer $200 credit for the first 30 days to our new Azure customers.
Okay.
Now, it was a good offer, and we got positive response from the customers. But as we started launching more and more Azure services, the feedback that we got from the customers was, I need more time to try out Azure, to learn Azure. That's the reason we created Azure Free Account. Mm-hmm. So the Azure Free Account, it's a new offer for new Azure customers, mm-hmm. which provide them $200 of Azure credit for the first 30 days, mm-hmm. plus 12 months of most popular Azure services. We are talking about VM, SQL Database, Cosmos DB. Along with that, they get access to 25 plus always free services. So it's a great offer for someone who wants to start learning Azure.
So if you're a hobbyist or a student or you're just trying it out for mm-hmm. your business mm-hmm. and you feel like you might need a couple of months
That's right.
kicking the tires, mm-hmm. having a site up,
yeah.
having a VM
yeah.
up in the
yeah.
cloud and running
yeah.
that.
Yeah, so it's a perfect offer for someone like that.
Mm-hmm. I do need a credit card. Mm-hmm. Will it be charged?
So all you need to sign up for an Azure free account is a phone number and a credit card.
Hmm.
Along with that, you need Microsoft account as well.
Right.
But the reason we need phone number and credit card is to validate your identity, is for identity verification. We really want to ensure that you are a real or a genuine Azure user or not a bot or someone who is trying to exploit the offer. But we will not charge your credit card unless you give us an explicit consent by upgrading your subscription to a pay-as-you-go subscription.
Mm-hmm. And is this available pretty much everywhere in the world?
So it is available in all the countries where Azure is available commercially, mm-hmm. except sovereign clouds, which is U.S. government, and Azure and Germany.
Sure. Yeah, I don't think the U.S. government needs a free trial.
That's right.
That's cool. So I signed up for the free trial, but you said that there's new things where I get free access to Cosmos DB, and you know they have a free tier as well. Do I get free websites and free
That's correct.
Machines?
So what you get with the new Azure free account is the credit itself.
Mm-hmm.
All the free tiers which you used to get, you still get all those free tiers of services.
Okay.
But along with that, there were certain services like VM. VMs did not have a free tier, or storage did not have a free tier. So what we are doing is we are providing select quantity of these services as well for free for 12 months.
Mm, okay, so for 12 months I get that for free in that free tier. This is just for new signups though,
That's right?
So if you already have an Azure account, this is not for you.
Yeah, this is not for you. This is just for new Azure customers. Mm-hmm. But if you are an existing Azure customer, as you said, we have free tier of a lot of services, 25 plus always free services which have free tier which you can use without paying for those services.
Just out of curiosity, and I don't mean to push this too hard, but like, what do I get for free? Can I do real work? Can I do interesting work? Can I have a small blog that I can do for free?
So you can do a lot of stuff, right? For example, I'll give you an example, virtual machine. The latest series of virtual machines that we launched was the B series, the burstable SKU. And we are offering burstable B1 VM for free with the free account.
Oh, wow.
If you're talking about SQL database, we offer S0 instance of SQL database. You can do a lot with S0 SQL database instance, right? So we are offering real quantities which you can use to do real work on Azure, do your POCs, learn Azure, and whatnot.
That's interesting. You're right, your proofs of concept, exactly. Mm-hmm. The idea that burstable SKU is interesting because I have used a number of small virtual machines, but they're basically small for very minimal work, but they're slow all the time.
That's right.
With the new B series, I can burst,
That's right.
get a little bit of extra power that I need to do the burst of work that I want to do. I've got, for example, a small newsletter that I send out. It only bursts a couple of hours a day, a couple of times a month.
That's correct.
That's a perfect example.
Yeah, so you can keep on accumulating your credit and then burst whenever you need more power.
What's the experience like when we sign up?
Sure. So it's very easy to get started. Mm-hmm. All you have to do is go to azure.com/free. Mm-hmm. That's a landing page for Azure Free Account.
Cool.
You'll find all the information on free account, what is included, offer terms, FAQs, etc.
Mm-hmm.
If you want to, if you're ready to start, then you can simply click on Start Free. Once you do that, you would need a Microsoft account to sign up for Azure Free Account. If you don't have one, you can easily create one. It's absolutely free. In my case, I've already created a Microsoft account, so let me actually quickly log in to my Microsoft account.
And a lot of people who are watching may not realize you may already have a Microsoft account. You may use it for your Hotmail. You may log into your Xbox with
That's
this.
Right.
So if you're a hobbyist or a student, you probably have a Microsoft account already that you don't realize.
So once you have logged in with your Microsoft account, you'll be taken to the signup page for Azure Free Account. And it's a pretty standard signup page. As I said earlier, all you need is a phone number and credit card. And the reason we ask for phone number and credit card is to validate your identity. That's pretty much it. We would not charge your credit card unless you give us an explicit consent by upgrading to pay-as-you-grow.
Okay,
so once you have filled this form and click submit, or click sign up, you'll have your Azure Free account. So I'm not going to go through the entire sign-up flow for the sake of time. But as soon as you do that, you have your Azure Free account. Mm-hmm. Now, once you have signed up for Azure Free account, you can then go to the Azure portal to start using these free services. So in my case, I've already signed up for a free account. So I'll give you a demo of how the experience work in Azure portal for free account users.
Okay. So this user who's logged in right now is a real free account user?
That's correct.
You don't have special powers?
No, I don't have any special powers.
Okay,
this is
cool.
A regular Azure free account.
Excellent.
So there are two things that I want to show specifically. One is how you can easily discover and create free services on mm-hmm. the Azure portal. And the second thing that I want to show is once you've started using free services, once you've started consuming your Azure credit, how can you keep a tab of it? How much services am I consuming? How much services are left?
Yeah.
All that information, right? So let's start with the first one.
Okay.
So I'll click on more services. I'll type free in the search box. I'll click on free services. So this is new Azure free services page. And on this page, this is a single pane of glass where you can find all the services which are available for free with your Azure free account.
Mm-hmm.
Now, it has two sections. The first section is services which are free for 12 months.
Mm-hmm.
As I said, these are some of the most popular Azure services. So we are offering 750 hours of B1S Windows virtual machine, 750 hours of B1S Linux virtual machine, SQL database, Cosmos DB.
Wow.
So these are the services which you get for free for 12 months. Then if I scroll down, this is the always free services. These are services which are always free. As you said, right, free tier of services which are always free for all users.
Mm-hmm.
Currently, this link is pointing to Azure.com, but in the future, we'll have all of these services listed on this page as well.
Mm-hmm.
So this will be, right.
Not to put too fine a point on it, but I can use, it's not saying I can do just this for 12 months. I can do all of this.
That's correct.
Each one of them. I
That's
can sign
correct.
Up for everything and play with all these things
That's correct.
Together.
That's correct. So you get all of this.
That's pretty slick.
So another cool thing about this page is that along with showing all the services which are available for free,
mm-hmm.
we have these create buttons. And what we have done is for some of the services, we have created custom templates or custom experience which make it very easy for you to create these free services.
Mm-hmm.
For example, if you want to create a free Windows virtual machine, you have to select the right region where
mm-hmm.
the B series is available. You have to select the right size of VM. You have to select the right managed disk. It's not that difficult,
mm-hmm.
but what we have done is we have customized the experience, which is very easy for you as a new user
mm-hmm.
to create these free services. So I'll give an example of that. So let's take an example. We want to create a free Windows virtual machine.
All right.
I'll click on create here. That will take me to a custom create experience for free virtual machine. As you can see, it's saying free account virtual machines, and I just have to enter 6 or 7 fields to create a VM.
That's really exciting because I have noticed that when I was first getting started with Azure and I make a new virtual machine, there are more options here
mm-hmm.
and a huge pricing section.
That's correct.
And I don't want to accidentally pick the wrong thing.
That's correct.
I'm just browsing.
That's correct. So this custom experience makes it super easy. All the variables that you have to select to create a free VM are pre-selected in this custom template. So let me quickly create a free VM. So the VM name, I can select an image. If I'm provisioning or creating a Windows server, I can select a Windows server image. If I want to provision a Linux VM, as I said, we also offer Linux VM as well.
Mm-hmm.
So if I want to select a Linux VM, if I want to create a Linux VM, I can select a Linux image. In this case, because we are provisioning a Windows VM, I'll select a Windows image. It's Windows Server 2016 data center. I'll pick a location where I want to deploy this VM. Username, password, confirm the password. Next, I would select the subscription which got created when I signed up for free account. It's the free trial subscription. I'll create a new resource group. The location for the resource group, I'll click on OK.
Mm-hmm.
It'll run some validations. And once the validations are done, I'll click on OK. And just like that, I have a free Windows virtual machine.
Mm-hmm. And this virtual machine, I can go into the billing section,
mm-hmm.
and I can see that predictive line that shows me how much it's going to spend
correct.
And how much
That's
it's going to cost.
So it takes some time for the usage to flow through the billing system,
okay.
but eventually you will see that in the billing blade or the subscription blade, and I'll give a demo of that blade as well.
That's fantastic. Because being, you know, we don't want to be, we the free people,
mm-hmm.
don't want you to think that we're being cheap. We're
mm-hmm.
just being careful and we're being thoughtful because we really want to understand how to effectively evaluate Azure
mm-hmm.
until we're prepared to start paying.
That's correct. So that was the free service page where you can discover and create free services. The next thing I want to show is the cost management functionality for free account users. Mm-hmm. So I'll click on cost management. I'll click on subscriptions. I'll choose the subscription, which got created when I signed up for free account. It's free trial in my case. And this is the subscription blade, which has all the information on cost and usage. Mm-hmm. So at the top, at the very top, there's a banner which basically shows you when your free credit is expiring. In my case, it is expiring in 6 days.
Right, and that's very clear.
That's very clear, right. Then below that, you have very vital information about the subscription, like the subscription name, billing period, et cetera. Now, if I scroll down, this is the cost by resource chart. So this chart will have information about all the services which I have used, which are not included for free. Mm-hmm. So any service, for example, if I spin up a service which is not included for free, this service will show up here. And I can check which services are consuming my Azure credit. So that's the information that you can gather from this chart. Currently, because it's a new account, I don't have any usage. It's not showing a lot of services here, but right. as you start using free services, all those services will start showing up here.
Right, within a day or two, it'll start flowing through the system.
The next chart is the spending rate and the forecast chart. This is a pretty cool chart. So it shows you your credit. What is the credit that you have available right now? Mm-hmm. How much of that credit have you used so far? So it's showing me that I haven't used anything, so I have my entire $200 intact.
Nice.
Then it also shows you the forecasted spend. So at the end of the month, how much of my credit will I consume?
And this is super useful, and I love this chart. And when it starts seeing the forecasted spend, I immediately pin that to my home screen,
you
and I would encourage everyone to do that to really get a sense of not just how much money you're spending, but how Azure uses your money in its compute resources.
That's correct. And if I scroll down further, this is the chart which gives you information about your usage on free services, right? So the first column on this chart is essentially the service itself, the meter name or the service name. Mm-hmm. The second column is usage and limit. So it tells you how much of the quantity is included for free for that service.
Okay.
And how much of that free quantity have I consumed? In my case, as I said, right, this is a new account. I haven't used a lot. Mm-hmm. So it's showing zero. But as you start consuming services, you'll see the numbers here. And we also show that information in the status bar. So that status bar will start filling. And the last column is status. So basically, based on your pattern, it will use an algorithm to predict whether you are going to exceed the limit for that free service.
That's so useful. I mean, it can't be any clearer. You really people are always afraid they're going to wake up and then it's going to cost them $1,000.
That's right.
You've got a progress bar.
Mm-hmm.
You've got a used and left. Mm-hmm. And you've got even a prediction in plain
That's
English
right.
or
That's
plain
right.
whatever language you speak.
That's right.
Likely to exceed, unlikely to exceed. It couldn't be clearer. And honestly, it's just trying to be very transparent about how you're going to spend your money in Azure.
That's right.
That's pretty slick.
That's correct. So using this page, you can easily keep a tab of your Azure usage and ensure that you are optimizing the benefits that you get with free accounts.
This is pretty cool. Is this in preview or is this now?
This is live right now. So as a new user, you can go in and you can sign up for an Azure free account.
So if you happen to bump into Azure Friday or you have a family member or a friend or a coworker or someone who hasn't had a great experience in Azure, they can sign up now, azure.com/free.
Yeah.
Fantastic. I am learning all about the new Azure free account here on Azure Friday.